everyone. And thank you for that lovely tribute Melissa put together for us. Welcome to the National Council of Jewish Women Chicago North Shores Hannah G. Solomon Award presentation to Senator Sara Feigenholtz. Thank you for joining us to celebrate Senator Feigenholtz's decades-long career serving the people of Illinois. Just a quick reminder, this event is being recorded, so please be mindful of that. Like so many of other events during the past 20 months, we were forced to cancel our in-person celebration planned for Senator Feigenholtz in 2020. But we did not want to miss the opportunity to show our appreciation for her leading the way in the passage of legislation that specifically speaks to NCJW's mission to improve the quality of life for women, children, and families. So here we are celebrating virtually again. I'm going to let others expound on her many accomplishments. However, I'd like to take a moment to share how Senator Feigenholtz impacted me and my family directly. From early in her career, Senator Feigenholtz has been instrumental in streamlining Illinois' adoption laws and advocating on behalf of all members of the adoption triad, adoptees, adoptive parents, and birth parents. She helped to bring about changes in Illinois law that made previously sealed private adoption records more accessible to adult adoptees, including being able to request an original birth certificate. Unsealing these records not only provided adoptees like my son with his family medical history, but a path to reunification if desired by both the adoptee and the birth parents. So I want to thank Senator Feigenholtz for helping to give adoptees throughout Illinois answers to so many of their personal history questions. And now I'd like to introduce Jan Schwartz, a member of our board of directors and the State Policy Advocacy Committee co-chair. She will now tell you a bit more about the Hannah G. Solomon Award.
Thank you, Debbie. I am so thrilled to be here tonight to honor Senator Sara Feigenholtz with the Hannah G. Solomon Award. It is through this award that we continue to pay tribute to those like Hannah who are dedicated to improving the quality of life for women and children and families, as well as safeguarding individual rights and freedoms. In 1893, before women could vote, and in the midst of the Gilded Age, when social reform was sorely needed to address the country's surging unrest and inequality, Hannah G. Solomon founded the National Council of Jewish Women. She organized and led the first Jewish Women's Congress earlier that year. It was part of the World Parliament of Religion at the Columbian Exhibition. She did so in response to being asked to bring her friends to serve coffee to the men during a prestigious meeting. Instead, Hannah created an ongoing forum that focused on improving the lives of women and children, especially immigrants and those living in poverty, so they would have improved working conditions, living conditions, education, medical care, and a path to learning more skills. You, like her, Sarah, are a woman of action. You, like her, have been a longtime champion of the rights of women and children. The Hannah G. Solomon Award is NCJW's highest honor that we present to a woman who has helped to change and expand the role of other women in vital areas of community life and whose leadership has motivated others to fight for change. It is my privilege to introduce Beth Nashberg to present you with the award. Beth is our section's past policy advocate, past director of advocacy, and by the way, my mentor. And she is also the creator and current lead of Spotlight, an amazing monthly educational program that focuses on advocacy issues. Take it away, Beth.
Hi, Sarah and friends. I'm so honored to be able to virtually present this award to you for National Council of Jewish Women, our Chicago North Shore section. Sarah, you developed a caring for others and acting to help at an early age. You watched your physician mother follow through to help patients beyond their medical needs, even when they came to your house. You saw passion and commitment firsthand. And you truly embody the spirit of Hannah G. Solomon in your career and as an elected official. Our award to you this evening is a way for so many persons, including so many you do not even know, to acknowledge your contributions to the residents of our state. This discussion tonight reminds me of the structure of a Talmud page, where the core text is at the center of the page, surrounded by discussions of what it means, how it relates to other important things, and how individual pages are part of a greater whole. And Sara, you are the center. Your core strength is your ability to connect the dots between what people need and finding ways to meet those needs. You have an outstanding ability to listen to the discussions of your constituents and to hear both what they say and the concerns they don't express, to identify their needs and respond to those needs with compassionate solutions. In doing so, you not only help your constituents, but residents throughout the state. And we've heard a few of those with the adoption, your help with passing HB 40 to get abortion for rights passed in Illinois, and this past year, this year, to repeal the Parental Notification Act. You've done so many things for the LGBTQ community, and you're starting to be involved in affordable housing. Those are just the top of things that we're aware of. So throughout your life and your career and your public service, you exemplify the highest ideals of public service and Judaism. Thank you for your service. And Sara, we'll have a few words from you, and then Merle will give a toast. Okay. So take it away, Sara.
No boring political speeches. But I'm going to show everyone this amazing award, a beautiful sort of a replica or a representation of Hannah Solomon. And it says, for outstanding service in carrying out the high purpose of NCJW, Chicago's North Shore chapter, in the tradition of Hannah G. Solomon. Big shoes to fill right here. This is big. You know, I think my cousin Esther is on this, maybe not. There she is, I see her. And I'm gonna talk a little bit about her, but I wanna thank Jan, Debbie, Beth, Merle, and everyone from NCJW for this award. It is, as Esther Schrager would have said, the ganze Geschichte. It's like the whole deal. You know, it's big, and for so many reasons, and you know, just, you know, I could go on and on, but you know, when I take a look at some of the folks that are on this, at this here online, I see people who are part of a much broader village whose values align. And Jewish women are, they're stubborn. I mean, it wasn't just my mother. You know, they're stubborn, they're resilient, they're creative. They understand their purpose, they're caretakers, they're problem solvers, they're breadwinners, and everybody on the here, you know, I see friends, I see colleagues like Michelle Alderman Smith and my birthday twin, Elaine Nekritz. I see my cousin, Barb Sarah Zablin, and the amazing Lori Chaitin. You know, these are the women in our village that many of whom raised me, Cheryl Gold, many of whom mentored me and, you know, introduced me to NCJW as the first Jewish women's organization to sort of step up and say, yes, we're pro-choice, and we believe that women should have the right to their own reproductive destiny and decide when they begin families. You know, and I think that, you know, I'm not done, I'm still going, and that flame inside of me still burns for justice, just like it does for all of you. Beth, when I see you walking on the street or at the Capitol, or you call me or send me an email, but you know, you're asking me what's going on with PNA. Like, it's, you cut right to the chase. We know this is important. We know this is an injustice, just like House Bill 40. You know, talk about injustices. You know, for Henry High to have prohibited the poorest women who needed access to reproductive health care and abortion care more than anyone. The right to that was, for me, a right that I had something I had to fix. It just really bothered me. And I got into some major arguments with some very powerful people in this state. And they tried to talk me out of it, and I didn't fold. I didn't fold. From Bruce Rauner to Mike Madigan, it didn't happen. And the craziest, most wonderful stories, worth the fight. I mean, it's really worth the fight. And now we see more than ever what is going on in our country around us. And we just have to keep fighting. We just have to keep fighting because we are in jeopardy. We are surrounded. It is circle the wagons time. So when it comes to the Supreme Court and what we're saying for our sister states around us. It's okay to have a weird childhood. It's okay to be adopted by a woman who's 56 years old and every moment of my childhood, you know, my mother used to drag me on house calls, and in the middle of the night, she would take me to Illinois Masonic and I would watch her deliver babies, which really turned me onto birth control. Very but to have our village of women and men who we have this pursuit of justice threaded through our lives. It is something that burns inside of us, and it's an unstoppable thing. Knowing right from wrong, questioning authority without fear, kicking the door down, and no one's going to hand it to us. We've got to fight. So I wish my mom was here. I'm not going to cry, but she was 4'9". She was like a dilettante wearing with rhinestone glasses, you know. She was just a pistol. And my family knows all too well how powerful she was. And I'm sure that when they see me, they see a lot of her. So again, what a great honor. This is really the whole thing. Thank you.
Thank you. I want to recognize something. Before Merle gives the toast, thank you so much. We want to recognize something else important. In your life, you've exemplified not just what it means to care about others, not just what it means to truly serve the public and government. You've shown what it means to put the ideals of Judaism into action. Healing the world is a Jewish imperative. Helping those in need is a Jewish principle. And recognizing our communal obligations is a Jewish commitment. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. And alibi.
Yep.
Merle. You're a girlfriend.
So I was writing, I was stretching my toast, which I had intended to be maybe three sentences, but it doesn't, because my cup overflows, Sara. And I want to begin with where your values and your ideals and your principles that you never leave outside your office door. And those two are reflected in your volunteer efforts in our community. I think it's very little known that Sara serves on the Chevra Kedisha of Anshei Emet. And somewhere I actually have a list of the number of times that she has been physically present where she has rushed back to be physically present and participate in this very, very important afterlife ritual. So she is very much pro-life, life and choice, and her behavior in the Senate. And I just wanted to say, this is the third time, the third cycle of time that you've been known as a freshman. And I know beginnings are, like Chaim Potok said in The Chosen, beginnings are hard. But I think you're going to have your arms around it almost immediately. I know and count on you for decades more of service in terms of crafting legislation and supporting it. It is your acknowledgement of all of the cracks in the sidewalks. It is your awareness, your advocacy, and your actions. You get four A's, and let it continue. Keep on firing away. Thank you. We love you, Sara.
Yep. Thank you, Sara.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
B'chaim.
B'chaim.
Mine was not grape juice, Merle. So, thank you all for spending a little time with us this evening to celebrate Sara. I wish we could have done more, Sara.
And in person. We and really person. Waited to the last minute till the year was almost over. We had right. hoped.
But
then you know what? We'll have more things to work on and more things to celebrate when we can get together.
Mm-hmm. That sounds great.
That sounds great. Mazel so thank tov. You all.
Thank you. Mazel tov. Thank yes. you again.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye. Good night. I got the eye of the tiger.